Welcome to History Handler. In this video, I'll address how Joseph Stalin became leader of the Soviet Union. The leadership struggle began in January 1924 following the death of Lenin, but there are multiple reasons why Stalin was able to oust his political opponents and rise to the top. Arguably the most important was his role as General Secretary within the Communist Party. He acquired this position in 1922 and it gave him significant control over the party. As well as having a seat at the Politburo, Stalin controlled the party membership and placed his most reliable supporters in key positions. Lenin himself had been concerned about the amount of power Stalin possessed and wrote the following in his final testament: "Comrade Stalin has unlimited authority concentrated in his hands, and I am not sure whether he will always be capable of using that authority with sufficient caution." This is rather ironic given it was Lenin who appointed Stalin in the first place. The role of General Secretary is certainly the most important, but there are other key positions as well. For example, in 1917, Stalin became Commissar of Nationalities. This enabled him to widen his contacts with the communists in the borderlands, many of whom were part of his entourage in the Kremlin later on. And in 1920, Stalin became Commissar of the Workers and Peasants Inspectorate, which in simple terms enabled him to monitor every aspect of the party and remove anyone he saw as inefficient or corrupt. Stalin's support of socialism in one country is also key to understanding his rise to the top. This policy gave the Soviet Union a sense of agency. They didn't need other countries to have socialist revolutions in order for their society to function in the way they wanted it to. They could create a socialist and ideally with time a communist society, and if socialism in one country was successful, the Soviet Union would go down in history as a guiding light for other states. Trotsky, who was one of Stalin's main opponents in the leadership race, did not support socialism in one country. He was on the far left of the Bolshevik Party and believed that in order for socialism to work, other countries would have to go through revolutions as well. This wasn't a very appealing idea for the Bolsheviks because it removes their independence. It makes the party reliant on other countries. Stalin knew this and used it to his advantage, and it's not the only time he was able to sense the direction of the tide and adjust his position accordingly. Towards the end of the 1920s, the new economic policy, also known as the NEP, started to run aground. The NEP had been brought in 1922 to aid economic recovery, but crucially, this policy had been unpopular with many Bolsheviks throughout the 1920s because it contained elements of free market capitalism. In other words, it contradicted the principles of the revolution. Stalin was well aware of the NEP's unpopularity despite the fact it was successful during much of the 1920s. But once the economy started to suffer once more, Stalin began to support a policy of rapid industrialization, which he knew would be popular with party members who had never liked the NEP in the first place. Rapid industrialization was radical, a swing towards the more idealist wing of the party that wanted the revolution to accelerate. Linking all these factors together is Stalin's ability as a speaker. He was a skilled orator with a knack for simple, straightforward speechmaking. He knew how to get his message across directly and clearly. One of his tactics was the use of a speech technique called hyperfora, which involves asking a question and then immediately answering it. This can be seen clearly in one of his speeches denouncing the NEP. "Does NEP abolish the dictatorship of the proletariat? Of course not. On the contrary, NEP is a specific form of expression and an instrument of the dictatorship of the proletariat." While Stalin was undoubtedly a gifted politician, it's also worth pointing out the mistakes of his opponents. Trotsky's support of a global communist revolution has already been pointed out, but he also made the mistake of underestimating Stalin, referring to him as a grey blur. He simply didn't see Stalin as a threat. Bukharin, who was on the right wing of the Bolshevik Party, used the phrase "enrich yourselves" when appealing to the peasantry during the era of the NEP. This, of course, was frowned upon by the majority of Bolsheviks who saw Bukharin as a capitalist sympathiser. What's more, when the NEP started to fail, Bukharin didn't come up with any solutions. Stalin's answer was rapid industrialization, but Bukharin had nothing. There are a multitude of factors, therefore, which contributed to Stalin's success in the leadership race. His role as General Secretary is the most important factor. This, more than anything else, was vital to his success. But the other factors should not be ignored, either. His support of socialism in one country, his denouncements of the NEP, his skills as an orator, and the mistakes of his opposition certainly helped him become leader of the Soviet Union. If you love history and want to learn more, make sure to hit the subscribe button and the notification bell. Thank you so much for listening, and I'll be back soon with another video.